Hey, what's up, guys? MKBHD here on SuperSAF TV.
This is Michael Fisher, aka Mr. Mobile, on SuperSAF TV.
What's up? This is SuperSAF for Austin Evans TV.
What's up, guys? This is iJustine on SuperSAF TV.
What's up, YouTube? It's Jaime Rivera from Pocket Now here on SuperSAF TV.
This is Conan Sigala on SuperSAF TV.
Assalam, everyone. It's Mr. Q from Rakami TV here on SuperSAF TV.
Hey, guys. This is Linus on SuperSAF TV.
Hey, guys. What's up? This is Jenna Ezerk on SuperSAF TV.
Hey, what is up, guys? This is Ash here from C4. Tech on SuperSAF TV.
Hey guys, I'm Michael Josh, your gadget matchmaker on SuperSAF TV.
What's going on, guys? This is John Rettinger on SuperSAF TV.
What's up, guys? I'm Tom the Tech Chap on SuperSAF TV.
What's up, guys? This is another generic white tech YouTuber here on SuperSAF TV.
What is up, guys? This is Faisal Saif on SuperSAF TV.
What's up, guys? Saf, you're on SuperSAF TV, and it's the one that you've all been waiting for. The end of year SuperSAF style collaboration with all of my friends, looking back at some of our favorite smartphones of the year. Now, most of us tech YouTubers do use more than one smartphone at any given time. So this year, they can choose more than one of the devices that they choose to use. Now remember, as we have every year, this will be part one, but there will also be a part two to this video where we'll be looking back at some of our favorite tech of 2021, not including smartphones. A bit of a YouTube tech rewind, shall we say. If you wanna see that first, then be sure to subscribe and hit that bell icon so you don't miss it. And let me go ahead and kick things off. So I always have two smartphones with me, one iPhone as well as one Android phone. The iPhone, I think, is a pretty easy guess. It is the iPhone 13 Pro Max. It's such a great all-rounder. We now have a ProMotion display with 120 hertz. I would say the best camera package on any smartphone when it comes to photos and video. And some of the best battery life on any smartphone. The iPhone 13 Pro Max lasts me all day long and then some. Now for the Android smartphone, this was really tough. But the one that I keep going back to this year has to be the Samsung Galaxy S21 Ultra. This was one of the first smartphones to come out this year, and it really set a benchmark for all of the other flagships. It ticks all of the boxes. You've got a very unique design with the camera module kind of melting towards the sides. You've got an excellent display, great all-round cameras, including some of the best zoom that you're gonna find on any smartphone. Good battery life. I mean, the S21 Ultra still holds up almost a year on. That's me. Let's see what the others have chosen.
The phone I used for 2021 was a bit of a surprise to me because normally I would have said the Fold, and I do use the Fold. But more often than not, I've found myself using the Galaxy Flip 3. More than the Razr, more than the Fold 3 even, because not only am I addicted to the fun factor, I love the pocketability, and I love that when it's open, it does pretty much everything I need an Android phone to do, except last all day and take the best photos. But the fun factor overrides that. So a delightful surprise, definitely my personal choice for 21. And it's purple.
Assalam, everyone. It's Mr. Q from Rakami TV here on SuperSAF TV. Thank you so much, bro, for having me again. And to answer the question, this is my favorite phone for 2021. Why? Well, first of all, I got small hands and I like the size of this phone. It is the most powerful phone yet again in this form factor. So that's number one. Number two, I also like the fact that they got the matte sides, and I hate fingerprints, and so this is the easiest thing to having an iPhone that's not gonna drive you insane constantly rubbing and wiping it down. And it kind of makes me sad that this is supposed to be the final year that we have a mini. That's what the rumors say. I hope the rumors are wrong.
Ooh. Yes, this is Conan Sigala on SuperSAF TV. Thank you for watching, because you know what? I'm here to tell you my favorite smartphone of, you know, 2021, what I use all the time. Of course, it's the Galaxy Z Fold 3, you know? I love it because it holds up close, but this year they have the S Pen, which means I can sign checks and I can sign divorce real quick, because times are hard, inflation is high, but Z Fold 3 is solid.
Hey guys, what's up? This is Jenna Ezerk on SuperSaf TV, and my favorite smartphone of 2021, or maybe smartphones, has to be the iPhone 13 Pro Max. Also, I've been enjoying the wallet as well. I'm an avid iPhone user, so obviously the new iPhone is gonna be my favorite. And for my Android, I actually have been using the Surface Duo 2. It's a great upgrade from the original Duo, and on one side, I can watch SuperSaf's TikTok, and on the other side, I can scroll on Twitter.
What's up? This is SuperSaf for Austin Evans TV, and today we're taking a look at some of my favorite smartphones of 2021.
Oh, here, I've been looking for
you lost those.
People can't see me without these.
Well, it's fine because we can cover that up now. My favorite phones of this year, starting out with, is the Z Flip 3. Look, I'm the biggest flippy boy around. I absolutely love this phone, but in my back pocket, I do carry an iPhone 13 Pro, mostly due to that incredible camera. Wait, can I have my glasses back? You're kind of ruining. Glasses. This is my channel. I don't know what you're doing here.
What are you doing on? What are you doing on my glasses?
This is Austin Evans TV.
Hey guys, I'm Michael Josh, your gadget matchmaker on SuperSaf TV. It's the end of 2021, and the phone that I've chosen to be my daily carry is the iPhone 13 Pro Max. Now, don't get me wrong, I still believe that the regular iPhone 13 is the gadget match for most people, but I'm a pro user. I'm always on my phone and I need that extra long battery life. Also, as a content creator, I need the flexibility that these three cameras provide, which also happen to be some of the best for both photos and videos. And finally, who can resist that beautiful Sierra Blue color?
What is up, guys? This is Faisal Saif on SuperSaf TV. Happy to be here, and happy to say that my choice for the best of these smartphones of the year 2021 would be definitely the Google Pixel 6 Pro. It's an obvious choice. I would have loved the Note to be instead of this, but well, it came with Android 12. It came with the latest of operating systems in the latest version from Android, as well as, well, it's just different. It shines up from all the other lookalikes, the diversity of name changing, nose fix change, and well, it's a good phone. I'm looking forward for the updates to fix some of the issues, yet it is a phone that I'm looking forward to take to the year 2022. And by the way, I do carry two phones at the same time. Got to be an Android and an iOS at the same time.
What's up, YouTube? It's Jaime Rivera from Pocket Now here on SuperSaf TV. Favorite smartphone of 2021 always ends up being a tie for me as I use two phones, and this year it's the smaller iPhone 13 Pro and the Samsung Galaxy Z Fold 3. I missed having a smaller iPhone that was just as powerful as the Max, and it's finally back as my social media and photography machine. Now, when I want to get productive, it doesn't get better than the Z Fold 3. S Pen functionality on this larger canvas that can then collapse to fit my pocket is something no other phone or tablet can take credit for. As always, Saf, thanks so much for having me.
What's up, guys? I'm Tom the Tech Chap on SuperSaf TV. So this is a tricky one because I've had my personal SIM card in a whole bunch of phones this year, as most tech reviewers do. At the beginning of the year, it was mainly the S21 Ultra. I actually then went to the Galaxy Z Flip 3 and also the Fold 3 for a little bit. But I have to say, and I'm gonna be really boring because I know most people are saying this, my favorite phone of the year has to be the iPhone 13 Pro and Pro Max, mainly because it's the first time in I think 4 or 5 years where I've properly switched to Apple. It also helped that I bought an Apple Watch Series 7 and I've got the terrific MacBook Pro 16. So I have gone to the dark side. I am now properly in the Apple ecosystem, but I'm having a pretty good time as well. And I really do like this phone. Even if it's nothing groundbreakingly different, it is probably the most consistent camera, incredible battery life, although a Pixel 6 Pro has been very interesting, and pretty much every member of my family has actually bought a Pixel, so there's very much a Google versus Apple fight going on in the house.
What's up, guys? This is another generic white tech YouTuber here on SuperSaf TV. And Saf, you know already that I don't ever really have like a daily driver phone. I kind of just switch to whatever phone I need to do a video on next, and that's just perpetually my life. But I will say that a phone that surprised me this year was the Pixel 6 and the Pixel 6 Pro. Honestly, the photos that come out of that are just still so good. On top of that, I feel like the rest of the phone now matches the camera. We have software that's really snappy, and the hardware itself just feels and looks a lot more like a proper
flagship.
Hey, what is up, guys? This is Ash here from C40 Tech on SuperSAF TV. And my favorite smartphone for 2021, it's gotta be the ROG Phone 5. I'm generally not a fan of bulky phones, but ROG has gotten so much right that I found myself going back to this a whole lot. I mean, even when I didn't have my SIM in it, it's been my go-to handheld gaming device all year. That combination of a high refresh AMOLED, the performance you get from the 888, especially when it's allowed to run cool thanks to that aeroactive cooler, and the insane battery life, it's been great. Personally, I've been using it with the Kunai gamepad for game streaming and some emulation, and I've been extremely happy with this setup. So that's my pick for the year, and thanks for having me, Saf.
What's up, guys? This is iJustine on SuperSAF TV, and my favorite smartphone of 2021 is... Okay, yes, of course, I know you guys expect me to pick an iPhone, and yes, obviously it is my favorite phone. Oh, I have a new voicemail. Isn't that lovely? On my not iPhone, my Samsung Galaxy Z Flip. I've loved this phone since the first version. The new Samsung Galaxy Z Fold was also an incredible device, but there's just something about this form factor that is just so incredible. So I'm super excited that they made some really crucial updates to this device this year. I'm getting kind of hyped up to see what they do with this next year.
I'm a big fan of Samsung's Galaxy Fold lineup, and in spite of the mediocre battery life and occasional software bug, I find the larger screen to be such a game-changing experience that I just can't put it down. I watch TV and movies on my phone often, and it is great for making edits to spreadsheets or remoting into my desktop or workstation. I also absolutely love it for reading articles, and especially ebooks. I almost never touch my Kindle anymore.
What's going on, guys? This is John Rettinger on SuperSAF TV. My phone of the year, probably unsurprisingly, has been a combination of the iPhone 12 Pro Max and the iPhone 13 Pro Max with a dash of foldable devices mixed in there. The iPhone has just made things easier for me to interact with family, with FaceTime, and then access to files that are back on my MacBook Pro.
Hey, what's up, guys? I'm KBHD here on SuperSAF TV, fresh off shooting a video back here. Okay. Now I'm a two phone person, so I've actually got two phones that I'm carrying on the daily. The main phone is a Pixel 6 Pro. It's gray. I like this one. And the other is the iPhone 13 Pro that I'm shooting this on in ProRes for a lot of the reasons, including the camera that you guys already know about. Yeah, really good phones this year. A lot of other phones I've used during this year have been great, but these are the ones that I'm using right now.
And there we have it, guys. The best of the best 2021. Some of the favorite smartphones of 2021 as chosen by some of your favorite YouTubers. What are your favorite smartphones of 2021? Do drop those down in the comments below. Remember, this is part one. There will be part two coming very, very soon. If you want to be one of the first to see that, then don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell icon so you don't miss it. Big, big thanks to all my friends for taking part again this year. This is the 7th year running that we've been doing this, and hopefully it will carry on for many, many years. Don't forget to check out all of their YouTube channels if you haven't already. They'll all be linked down in the description below. I hope you enjoyed this video and found it useful. If you did, then do smash that like button for me. Thanks for watching. This is Saf on SuperSAF TV, and I'll see you next time.
I didn't think of an answer for you, Saf.
Ha 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 ha!